Hi there, welcome to our first episode of Fans Life for the 2011-2012 season right here on Hua Sports. And of course, we're giving homage to the United supporters over here as they have the season opener together with Manchester City in the Charity Shield. So yeah, the game just got underway, so let's just find out the sentiments of the United supporters ahead of this one. I've got also Afiq and D-Guy here with me. First of all, new players, pemain baru Ashley Young, David De Gea. Macam mana percaturan untuk musim baru ni, Afiq?
Saya rasa mungkin Sir Alex Ferguson akan menggunakan Ashley Young dengan kelab lah. Mungkin Ashley Young akan mula bermain menjadi pilihan lebih lah daripada Park Ji-sung.
Alright, dalam off-season United memang performance dia memang bagus dekat US. Alright, all in. Macam mana you ingat tentang game ini? Adakah ini akan menjadi macam benchmark untuk season ni sebab Man City currently now are your biggest rivals?
Saya rasa bukannya biggest rival, dia orang biggest rival sebab sebab banyak spending untuk beli-beli player dan duit tak akan membeli kemenangan, kejayaan. Seperti kita lihat beberapa musim yang lepas, siapa yang menang Charity Shield dia akan menang Premier League. So I think Man United akan menang game ni dan dia akan menang Premier League lagi untuk yang kali ke-20.
That's right. So early part of the season, they already looking forward for their 20th title, but it could be anybody's game. So final question, siapa ingat man to watch for United untuk game ini?
Saya rasa Nani.
Dan untuk Man City, siapa yang ingat akan menjadi pencabar utama dari Man City?
Dari City, I think dia orang tak berapa apa tu lah, tak ada key player lah dia orang main tu. Rasanya semuanya biasa je lah, tak ada tu. Harapkan Zeko, mungkin Zeko belum lagi adapt dengan English football. Baru 2 goal I think so far, but I think Man United will win lah. Tak ada siapa nak tengok lah. Man United boleh kongkong semua player Man City untuk malam ini.
Okay, so there you have it, their reaction to it. They already very bullish, very confident about the season. So the game just got under. We'll come back with our 15 minute update in a little while right here on Fans Life. Come up with a 15-minute update in a bit. Oh, it was just an attempt by Wayne Rooney. Close, but didn't get it. But it was a fiery first 10 minutes of the game between Manchester United and Man City. Either end's also doing pretty well. But then now in about last 5 minutes, the game has fizzled out, has calmed down a little bit. But it certainly is an exciting one, getting the fans here a little bit excited. At the moment, it stands 0-0, and we'll come back with another update in 15 minutes' time. Right, it's 30 minutes into the game. It's one-way traffic. It's all Man United, but it's still 0-0. But the defensive side for Man City looks a bit frail. They're a little bit edgy. But we've got one tweet here from Swamp Jenkins that says, "I miss Tevez." Tevez isn't in the starting 11, but we'll find out what happens when we come to halftime in 15 minutes' time. It's still United 0, Man City 0 in the Charity Shield. Oh! It's a goal for Manchester City by Julian Lescott in the 38th minute. Can you see me? Can you see me? It's a goal to Man City. So it's City 1, United 0 when United were doing all the work. And it's a free kick that Julian Lescott, who probably looks like a Klingon, he scored the goal. So it's City 1, United 0. Very quiet here. Just at the stroke of half-time. Can you see me now better? Much better. Just at the stroke of half-time, Edin Dzeko scores number 2 for Manchester City, and they have gone 2-0 up in the first half. What a brilliant strike from Edin Dzeko from about the 18-yard box, right outside the 18-yard box as we see the replay right now. He goes through one. The defenders right in the centre just gave him room. Well, it's kind of quiet here with the United fans. We'll come back and speak to them at half-time of their sentiments of how United, who are controlling the match, and now see themselves 2 goals behind in the first half of the Charity Shield. More when Fans Life continues. Right, it's halftime here at Mukmin Restaurant together with the Manchester United fans. Not very good because they are down by 2 goals. I'm here with Syed and also Param. Now, first half, guys, Manchester United memang controlled the first half. They were playing very well. What do you think went wrong during the whole game
in the first half?
Wrong is from the first goal is from Ferdinand, Rio Ferdinand. So he left the say let's go there. So it's a very difficult one. But the second goal is the keeper should be alert.
Keeper should be alert. Yeah.
But tapi bila kita tengok goal tu kan, bila Edin Dzeko bawa bola in front of the penalty box, kedua-dua centrum defender tu dia berpisah. Satu pergi sebelah sini, satu pergi sebelah sana bagi dia ruang. You think kan ada sedikit masa untuk Vidic dengan Ferdinand sebab mereka dah lama bermain bersama.
Ha. Saya rasa mungkin kesilapan kat sini mungkin masalah miscommunication antara dua pemain tu. Mungkin dia sudah agak seorang di tengah kan, tapi kita nak tengok macam mungkin ada kesilapan dari segi miscommunication lah. Lepas tu De Gea pula dalam keadaan yang mungkin dia dah macam apa kata, mungkin dia ingat defend boleh hold bola tu. Jadi mungkin dia ada bagi saya kasi masalah miscommunication lah.
But up front kita tengok Rooney, Welbeck, Nani memang ada got some movement there. But do you think Welbeck can still continue as the central striker?
Welbeck can still continue, but have to change Ashley Young.
Ashley Young.
So the problem memang dekat in the midfield lah.
Yeah. Bukan dari segi itulah, kita ada banyak peluang nak pergi, tak ada luck nak score je lah.
So now it's all up to luck because they had the chances but apparently no luck to score. But we'll see what happens in halftime. Maybe they need somebody in midfield, maybe if they buy Wesley Schneider in time he could play, but I don't think so that's going to make a difference. But we'll find out. The United fans are still hopeful that they can do something in the second half, and we'll find out the reaction to the Charity Shield match. It's still Man City 2, United 0. How timely is that? Right at the start of the second half, 5 minutes into it, United equalise. And they've come alive. And as they watch the replay, it's Chris Smalling who gets one back for United. So it's a game on for the Charity Shield. It's a Man City 2, United 1. Here come United again. Here come United. Oh, and it's an equaliser. It's an equaliser. No, it's just a good game. United 2, Man City 2. Game on. One on one, can he score for the winner? Yes, he does! United still in through an error by Company. Vincent Company made an error in the middle of the park. Nani goes all the way, one on one with the keeper and scores. It's United 3, Man City 2, and looks like United will clinch the Charity Shield. For the Charity Shield, the curtain raiser for the 2011-2012 season. Manchester United came from 2 goals down to win it by 3-2. We'll join the guys later for the full-time match report, including a chat with the legend now they call here in Man United, Malaysia. Raj, the guy who got his shirt taken out at the Liverpool training match. We'll have more right here on FansLife when we continue. Yeah. right, it's our full-time match report here at Fans Life. The first one for the 2011-2012 season together with the Man United fans. We've got Isme here and also Raj. Looks like the guy who was at the stadium, but he's not. They all look alike. Maybe because of the red shirt, I'm not too sure, but it's not him. But we'll talk about the game. You were down 2-0 first half. Second half, you came back. Who do you think was the most influential person on the United side in the second half?
I think the midfield got better at the second half. So the first half, it was quite okay. Our attacking side was good. Some mistakes by the defending side and two goals plus.
Isme, you ingat masa halftime tu United memang boleh bangkit dan come back in the second half?
I believe so because kita ada banyak sejarah pasal comeback kan, like 1999 and the previous season tu bila kena tinggal dengan Blackpool final game 2-1 kita bounce back 4-2 eh, 4-1 4-2 like that eh. But it's a thrilling game.
Yeah, I think one of the best community shields or charity shields we've seen in a while. But let's talk about some of the new players. Your take on the more influential role played by Chris Smalling, Phil Jones, David De Gea and Ashley Young. What do you think of their performance?
At the first half, De Gea was quite not okay, I think, because Manchester United two goals and the second one is quite easy to save. Didn't look that way. At the second half, it was okay. I think it was okay. Two stunning save.
So hopefully Alex Ferguson didn't give the hair dry treatment during halftime lah. But anyway, they always say that whoever wins the charity shield goes on to win the title. So do you think this is going to be another United season?
I don't know what to say. Football bloody hell. But I think yes, because tengok balik history, every team yang menang charity shield will win the Premier League, and I believe we will win the 20th Premier League. This is
it. Well, what a question to ask a United fan. Of course, they're going to say they're going to win the 20th title, but it's going to be a long, long season. Full fixtures get underway next week, and you have a tough one. 2 weeks after that, it's going to be United versus Spurs. That's going to be another cracker. We'll find out what's going to happen, but so long from all of us at Hoo-Ha Sports and our first Fans Life right here for the 2011-2012 season. Join us right here at hoo-ha.my for the whole season as we join the fans, the United fans, and all the other fans here in Malaysia.